makes it so funny. So there's the green. That it was definitely a color mistake. That's why we switched back.
He's got the camouflage now going into PS2.
That's true. I didn't even think about that. All right, so revenge stacks are going to be super important in this match. He's got to like make sure that he sets it the tone to Suarez that you can't consistently zone him with eggs. And Suarez has to constantly grab him because he needs to make sure there's no out-of-shield game like Nair's or any neutral beast.
Mm-hmm. Although we're seeing right now, it doesn't look like 6AM has gotten quite a chance to get his offense started. Suarez sort of been in his face, getting a couple good conversions here. Chase off the Nair actually waits to see what the option is.
Yeah, and Suarez, oh, all right, yeah, you let that one go. That way you can go ahead and get stage.
Oh,
he got the double jump. Right, you take those every day.
There it is. There it is.
That's what I'm talking about. He's such a troll. That's your jump, though, and you're dead.
All right. So Suarez taking it back real quick. Shoot, it's good to see stuff like that. I mean, it's BM, but it's funny.
Hey, you know what? You take it, man. Also, what we just saw out of Suarez, too, is a big key factor in this matchup. Suarez has to establish offstage pressure perfectly because Itzenor doesn't have the best recovery in the world.
Mm-hmm. That might be it right there. I don't know if he has a jump. Oh, he does have his jump. Very good.
Yeah, just taking intentional hits and died there as well. So a zero to death return from Suarez.
Shoot. I wonder if he was holding away on that one, trying to drift away and perhaps got caught with bad DI.
Might have been, possibly, trying to avoid maybe a follow-up fair off of the hit. Mm-hmm. Now, this happened earlier, too, with a couple sets where he goes down early lead, but Suarez with the lead is great because that means you have to approach him. It makes his nairs better, and it makes his F-tilt better because this is a big boy. He's going to combo him.
Mm-hmm, absolutely. And Incineroar, definitely on the slower end of the cast. If you're going to approach, it will be a little bit telegraphed, and Yoshi with some really strong out of shield options. The rising nair, rising up tilt, or up tilt, up air even.
Yeah, so. And even you just saw six like, oh! Okay, so he only got an up air out of that, but he was doing a solid job of kind of frame trapping Suarez a bit there, but with the stock lead up, again, well, you're dead now. It doesn't matter how heavy Yoshi is, you ain't living Alolan Whip.
I haven't seen Alolan Whip in a hot minute, but that's one good move.
Right. Yes, sir.
All right, just tossing out an egg, trying to be careful on that one. Suarez mixing up his landing, taking control of center stage now. And Suarez can play this a little on the slower end here if he doesn't want to try to proc revenge stocks, because that could lead to some very big upsetting
hits. I agree with that 100%, because even though Suarez isn't necessarily the biggest fan of timeouts or anything like that, he literally was upset when he had to timeout Melvin recently at an encore event. Mm-hmm. But sometimes when you see a character like Incineroar, like you said before, one of the slowest characters in the game, mm-hmm. you don't want to keep approaching him, because this is what happens.
See, and stuff like that too. That's a really good angle to send out. Yeah, just go for it again.
Yeah, just keep that pressure up. You already got him on shield a few times. Now you got to watch out for egg toss at the ledge or just go aggressive with a Alolan Whip again. And it might beat out Nair too, because you got that small bit of armor on a Alolan Whip.
Yeah, and the thing about it, right, is that it occupies a really good space in the mid-range, because Yoshi Suarez could play it out like, oh, no way. He's alive. Jeez. Okay. Chasing with the up air, managing to get back down. Suarez in a good position with the egg now.
Oh, with the Nair. There goes his double jump. He almost catches him with the back air. Six is very good at jump reads from the ledge, so he's got to watch out for that.
And we see a lot of respect from Suarez there on the Alolan Whip. Very active move. Very scared to try to jump into it and potentially go.
Oh, no shield break.
Really?
Up throw, that's it. Wait, no, back throw. I'm surprised he didn't go for up throw in that position. I figured up throw might KO, especially with rage and with the, but I guess Yoshi weight, not enough.
See, this is the thing, right? If you want to play this mid-range, you have to deal with, okay, so Alolan Whip can just come out at any time and I can die.
Yeah.
And it's really scary, but if you don't play it, nice. If you don't play that mid-range, then Incineroar just gets to walk in on you.
Yeah, like in the way that you saw Suarez, like Suarez understood the respect he had to give. He was trying to go for a back air because that's the KO option for Yoshi at that point. Mm-hmm. You get dragged down back air into a follow-up, or you get back air as a raw KO. But also, Nair, that move, is going to get beat out by Alolan Whip on quite a few positions, so you have to be super scared, and you can't F-tilt to try to find an up air. Mm-hmm. So it forces you to play frightened of the potential death that is incoming with Incineroar.
And it's not even just that it's got the range as well, but if you've already committed to move, because Smash jumps don't counter grabs on this one, you're probably not, even Yoshi, who's got like a pretty good jump, you're probably not getting out of the way of that in time.
Yeah,
if it's like last second, you're not going to shield it. You might be able to spot dodge or roll out of the way, but that's more like a prayer at that point.
Exactly. You like at KO percents against Incineroar, sometimes you're really just reaching for a prayer, like just like nooch in a dream and just hope you don't get punished. But all that literally was just like he missed that one grab finally. He tried to condition him to get the timing on that because he kept doing Alolan Whips before. Mm-hmm. So hopefully he gets him on shield at that point. But Suarez saw through it. As we run here to Battlefield as the second pick, how are you feeling about this counter pick?
I don't know how I feel about the counter pick. I do feel like Yoshi will benefit from the platforms in terms of combo potential. We have seen 6AM get out of these with a little bit of the neutral B. We saw that up B early on game one, which I think was an interesting call. If he's able to utilize it really well to get in on Yoshi and sort of threaten places, I think it could be a very good pick, though. But we'll see. I'm not exactly versed in Incineroar. I don't think many are.
Well, I... So I live with one, then I have six. We have a random amount of characters. We have multiple Pac-Mans. We have multiple Wii Fits, and we have Incineroars. I don't know what Connecticut is anymore. We used to be eight foxes. But, like, now, I do agree with the fact that six wait here because six loves the stage as a counterpick, personal favorite for him. Mm-hmm. He's really good at conditioning people at the ledge, particularly off of pressure like that.
What was that?
Oh, he tried to catch
Why
a jump out of
the
shield.
Why did it almost work?
It's just, like, you have to be unorthodox with a character like Incineroar mm-hmm. to succeed. And that back air,
nice.
Calling him out from the ledge, really good stuff. But I do heavily agree with the fact that Suarez gets heavy combo potential. Mm-hmm. I think the thing is... Ooh. Yeah, so Yoshi struggles to kill at higher percent, so that might work out in the favor of Incineroar, which right here just lived at 154 off that back air.
Mm-hmm. And we saw right there Suarez being a little patient and cautious with the eggs in the previous game one, and that's why if we see some revenge stocks on there, Incineroar becomes even scarier to mm-hmm. approach. He gets more stage Ooh. Than he just gets to take.
Oh, look at this advantage state right now. All right, gets hit by the down air, but Suarez, like, if I'm Suarez, I need to win at ledge, like right here. He doesn't get to... Oh! He stepped the jump, but he couldn't get anything afterwards. Good job from Suarez at least catching the up air after, because this is starting to look bad.
Oh, shoot. He didn't get his jump. Did he? No, he didn't. Okay, cool.
I thought he caught it, too, with that down tilt at the ledge.
Yeah, I was like, did he get that jump? All right, so up on the platforms. This is another thing that I think it might help for, Incineroar's landing, because he is quite slow. If you've got a low aerial drift, that can be very difficult to get down, especially against someone with very good air mobility like
yep.
Yoshi. So we are seeing that come into play a little bit here.
It's very similar to the Little Mac approach of how you think Little Mac would struggle on Battlefield overall, but they go here because it gives them different landing options and different abilities to catch tech chases on ledge, but you don't need one when you got Suplex City coming through. Mm. You gotta drop that one at least once during the set with Incineroar.
His throws are so cool, man.
They're all dumb.
They're stupid good, but he's a grappler. They should be.
True right. enough.
Got the egg up there. A little bit of damage.
Up throw is all no right. longer the the backbreaker or whatever it's called. It's just Pop Buster now because of Guilty Gear.
Nah, that's right. All right. That's going to give him stage control with the Alolan Whip.
Oh, tries to catch the jump again. Falling up air is not going to do it just yet, but if he gets him mixed on here, does he catch him on the ledge get up? Yes, he does!
Yo, look at that seven-layer dip mix-up! Jesus! Empty hop friggin' down smash!
That was so smart after all the pressure he's put out before, but this ledge game pressure right now, can he get by the down tilt? Oh, it just gets hard yeah. red on the up smash after going for that!
Yep, it's very tough to feel. Okay, no, he's still alive. Ops to go for the kill off the top. Doesn't quite do it with Yoshi. But yes, it's very tempting for Yoshi to jump from the ledge with an aerial thunderstorm. Yo, he's dead!
Yo, the mash out downer, the aggressive downer, just getting out of there was so smart. It's risky because it does put you in end lag and you can't get punished, but you're probably not dying today in that situation, so why not?
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, honestly, when you're playing characters like this who do have exploitable weaknesses, sometimes mm-hmm. you do have to take those risks.
True enough.
And we see, 6AM definitely going for some of the wacky stuff like there. Like the forward smash on the platform. It's like, yeah, this is a hard, hard jump call out.
Yeah, and even with that, like, the way that he's been conditioning Suarez with these jump backers, he's forcing the fear. Like, hey, I'm going to read this jump. So what do you have to do in that position? You're more scared to land in that same spot. So he mixes it up on the roll read or a short hop read.
Oh,
but still, I got to give credit where credit's due. Suarez has been playing the match incredible at the start.
Look at this read.
Dude, hard, hard read right there. But I am so thoroughly impressed mm-hmm. by how Six has been playing this because Suarez is godlike.
Yeah, Suarez is super good. Playing it a little patient. Tossing up. Oh. Look at the reaction on the egg. Very nice. Got the revenge up. Not going to get to use it right away, though, as Yoshi gets a clean 65% on him.
Yeah, enough damage to just literally remove that revenge stack from the picture. So even after that, you take 65% for getting one counter.
Does damage remove the revenge 30%. Earlier? Oh,
yep.
I didn't know.
Yep, grabs are 30. I believe it's 30 or 35%. Fairly certain it's 30. That gets rid of the revenge deck. Yo, double jump armor coming in clutch
yep,
momentarily. Still, he's still getting still getting pushed.
Still eating a lot of damage here, trying to get back to the stage. 6 a.m. with all the right answers on this one. Full control. What's the option going to be?
Yeet!
Alolan Whip, very dead.
You,
super dead. No DI will save you from that.
So accurate to the fact that he just kept catching. Like, that whole start was all Suarez. Mm-hmm. And then every single defensive option was called out. It wasn't even true combos. It was just regularly mixing. That, though, you got away with it last time. That ain't going to work every time.
Yep, very good. And it actually does get him on the second hit of the shield on that one. I don't think I've ever seen before Yoshi missing the second hit on the shield break like we did in the first game.
Yeah, it's not too often. And Suarez is very good at that. Oh, that would have. Oh, that's two. Run. Run for your life. Run away. All right, there you go. Get the grab.
Nice.
Punish that.
Good punish. That should be some nice damage. Put him in. Goes for the reset on the re-grab. All right, yeah. Egg is in play. Very patient on that one. Doesn't want to get blown up by anything.
And that's why. That's 100% why you saw Suarez being super patient at the ledge. You do not want to catch that down throw to fair or a possible follow-up on whip. He keeps trying to call him out on these jumps out of shield, maybe on a nair out of shield.
Mm-hmm. And we actually have seen, it looks like Yoshi's shield actually puts him low enough that he's not getting swiped by a Alolan whip, which is very strong. Good option to have. All right, gets him with the re-grab, toss him off stage.
Oh, that's the jump.
Gonna opt for a ledge trap here. Not looking to get reversed by that Alolan whip he's learned from game one.
Yeah, you stay on the move. Stay on the go. Do not be within the mid-range of Incira because of that right there. That time was off the platform.
Mm-hmm. He's got all the time in the world. Yep. Keeping him off stage.
And that's a stop.
Yep.
100%, that's a stop. 6 a.m. coming, like 6 a.m. coming through, putting this type of W on. It gets the parry that time.
Nice. All right, very good. Still gets hit by the grounded hit, but that's a lot better than getting shield broken.
And as scary as it was, I heavily agree with Suarez trying to go off stage like that. He hasn't gone off stage that much, so you wait for the Alolan whip first and you throw out the nair. Now you got to try and get the stock, but don't overdo it because we saw it the very third stock of the game. Mm-hmm. Now, down beyond a shield, winner moves on. Pools of winner semis only. This looks like a winner's quarters type match we got going on right here.
Yeah, this is. I can't believe this is still pools, man. This is crazy. All right. Oh, actually goes for the down tilt on that one. I thought that was going to be another grab. All right. Playing the mid range.
Oh, called the jump.
Pushed off from center stage here. 6 a.m. with some really good control here. Suarez trying to look for an opening to get back.
Yeah, I think that's what we're going to see a lot of Suarez. There you go. Catch the jump with the nair. I mean, excuse me, down air. He's been jumping a whole lot in front of you. You need big damage. Punish that with the command grab. There you go. Mm-hmm.
Very strong option, but very punishable option, especially if you have a nice disjoint like Yoshi's disjointed grab. Punish it.
Cross chop out of shield. Going to get him percent lead back. That's a revenge stack. You got to watch out for your landing. Back air can do it. Up air. Up smash can do it. Indy. Upset coming through for 6 a.m. over Suarez in the 2-1, moving on in the qualifiers. I am so happy I brought this dude out because he has absolutely been the most improved Connecticut player this season. I am so mad to watch Suarez die, though. I love Suarez, but sometimes it just happens, man. And it's 6 a.m. putting in the work. What an incredible play from an Incineroar in the matchup. That's kind of hard to, like, deal with all those grabs.
Because, see, the thing